I'll be right beside you, no matter where you travel. I'll be there to cheer you till the sun comes shining through. If we're ever parted, I will keep the tie that binds us, and I'll never let it break, 'cause I love you. I will bring you honey from the bee tree in the meadow, and the first time there's a rainbow, I'll bring you a pot of gold.
I'll take all your troubles and I'll throw them in the river, then I'll bundle down beside you and I'll keep you from the cold.
I'll be right beside you, no matter where you travel. I'll be there to cheer you till the sun comes shining through. If we're ever parted, I will keep the tie that binds us, and I'll never let it break, 'cause I love you. Yes, I'll sweep out your chimney, yes, and I will bring you flowers.
Yes, and I will do for you most anything you want me to.
If we live in a cottage, you will feel like it together by the road. I'll sweep out your chimney, yes, and I will bring you flowers, yes, and I will do for you most anything you want me to.
If we live in a cottage, you will feel like it's a castle, by the royal way you're treated and attention shown to you.
I'll be there beside you if you need a crying shoulder, yes, and I'll be there to listen when you need to talk to me.
When you wake up in the darkness, I will put my arms around you and hold you till the morning sun comes shining through the trees.
I'll be right beside you, no matter where you travel. I'll be there to cheer you till the sun comes shining through. If we're ever parted, I will keep the tie that binds us, and I'll never let it break, 'cause I love you.
I knew that I would know Friends and family, good evening and welcome to Savannah and Chad's wedding. As we get started, I'd like to remind us that now is a good time to silence our cell phones so that we can all experience and enjoy this celebration without distraction. We are gathered here this evening to celebrate one of life's greatest moments, to give recognition to the worth and to the beauty of love, and to add our best wishes to the words which shall unite Savannah Cornelius and Chad Hungate in marriage. Let's pray. Father God, as we gather here this evening, we know that you are present with us. And so we claim our time together, and we claim the marriage of Chad and Savannah in the name and the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. May your Holy Spirit minister to us today, and may your abundant blessing and favor be on Chad and Savannah as they commit themselves to each other in marriage and begin their life as husband and wife. Amen. Amen. Marriage is in itself a blessing, but doubly blessed is the couple who comes to the marriage altar with the approval and love of their families and friends. Who has the honor of presenting this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
You may be seated. Deep breath. Today is your day. You made it. And we all know that today was not the original date that you had planned. But for reasons beyond our control, we had to postpone. And we could have done it different. We could have gotten me and you two and a couple witnesses and done this and then had a celebration later. But that's not what you wanted. You wanted this. You wanted this venue surrounded by your family and your friends. You wanted this the day you said, "I do." And so today is a special day. It's your wedding day. And perhaps because of all that we've been through the last couple months, today becomes even more special for you. And I just want to encourage you to enjoy every minute of it. Earlier, I was thinking back to when we met for coffee at Jolts and Juice a few months ago. We met so we could start planning for today and Savannah, so that I could get to know you. I had heard about you from Chad at our after practice talks, and I wanted to connect with you and get to know you. And I also wanted to connect with the two of you as a couple. Of course, Chad, I've known you for several years now. First as a player on my basketball teams, and now coaching together, and as a friend and as a peer. And I've learned over the years what kind of man you are, and you're a good one. How much you care about other people and your relationships with them. How you deliberately make decisions and stick to your commitments. How working hard and integrity are important to you. How much joy you have in life, and how loyal you are. And Savannah, if you remember when we met for coffee, I asked you to share your story with me, and you did. And I was so impressed, and I continue to be so impressed with who you are as a person, as a mother, as a child of God. And as I shared with you that day, you are an inspiration. And as I think about the person you are, I think about God's grace and his mercy and his love, and I'm blown away by your determination, your resilience, your caring and compassionate heart, and your desire to be who God has created you to be. Before today, you lived your life as individuals. And now in marriage, you are becoming one. In the Bible, in the book of Mark, Jesus references the book of Genesis when he says, "But at the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. And for this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one." Bring all of who you are into this relationship. Understand each other's strengths. Understand each other's uniqueness. And flourish together. You are establishing your own identity as a couple and as a family. You continue to honor and stay tied to your families. But you are now setting yourselves apart as your own family. And in Scripture, in the book of Ephesians and also in Colossians, we get a glimpse of what the family dynamic in this relationship looks like and how we are to honor and love each other. It says to submit to one another out of the reverence for Christ. It says, wives, submit yourselves to your husbands as is fitting in the Lord. And husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her. And this is something you do every day. In humility, you care for each other. You honor each other. And you always want what is best for each other. It also says in Ephesians and Colossians, do not exasperate your children. Instead, bring them up in the training and in the instruction of the Lord. Do not embitter your children, or they will become discouraged. So I want to acknowledge the gift of parenthood and what an honor and a responsibility that is. And so Chad and Savannah, as you not only join together, but you come together as a family, and as you parent Cody, as you train and raise him, I encourage you to honor and respect him by always trying your best as parents. And when we met for coffee, I asked you both a very simple question. I said, "Chad, why do you love her?" And I said, "Savannah, why do you love Chad?" And in your answers, there was significant depth and thought. And I'm not going to share what those answers are, but you know what they are. I want you to hold on to those reasons and those things you shared. I want you to always keep in mind those things about each other, those things that stop you in your tracks about each other, those things that are unique to each of you and that you love about each other. And know this, as you commit yourselves daily to each other, the love you share will only grow. And I'd like to encourage you with these words from 1 Corinthians 13 as to what love is. And may these words be a guiding force in your marriage. Love is patient. And love is kind. And love does not envy. It does not boast. And love is not proud. Love does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking, nor is it easily angered. Love keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. Love always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails. As we continue, Savannah and Chad, would you please turn and face one another and join hands as you express your love and your commitment to each other by exchanging your vows of marriage. Chad, would you please repeat after me as you speak these words of commitment to Savannah? I, Chad, take you, Savannah, to be my wife, to share the good times and hard times, side by side, as husband and wife. I humbly give you my hand and my heart as a sanctuary of warmth and peace, and pledge my faith and love to you. And now, Savannah, would you please repeat after me as you speak these words of commitment to Chad? I, Savannah, take you, Chad, to be my husband, to share the good times and hard times, side by side, as husband and wife. I humbly give you my hand and my heart as a sanctuary of warmth and peace, and pledge my faith and love to you. May I please have the wedding rings? The wedding ring is a symbol of eternity. It is an outward sign of an inward and spiritual bond which unites two hearts in endless love. And now, as a token of your love and your deep desire to be forever united in heart and in soul, Chad, would you place this ring on Savannah's finger, and as you do, repeat after me. Savannah, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love and faithfulness to you. By the same token, Savannah, you may place this ring on Chad's finger, and as you do, please repeat after me. Chad, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love and faithfulness to you. Chad and Savannah have chosen to braid three strands together into a single cord. Each strand has significant meaning. The white strand in the middle represents God and His majesty, and then the two brown cords represent Chad and Savannah and their lives as individuals. In braiding these three strands together, they are demonstrating and proclaiming that their marriage is more than a joining of two lives together. It is a unity with God as well. They have chosen to allow God to be at the center of their marriage, woven into every aspect of it. Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verses 9 through 12 says this: two are better than one because they have a good return for their labor. If either of them falls down, one can help the other up. But pity anyone who falls and has no one to help them up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken. Chad and Savannah are now going to move to the front, and they're going to braid these three cords together into a single strand. And while they do, a song will play. And I would encourage you, as they do this, that you participate with them by praying for them and for their marriage.
You. You know. always be there when you're down. When you're down, take a look all around. Now. I'm sorry, but I'm just thinking of what I used to say. I know they don't sound the way I planned them to be. If you wait around for a while, I'll make you fall for me.
Today you have been woven together by God as one in marriage, one man, one woman, and God. It was God who taught us to love. And Savannah and Chad, by keeping him at the center of your marriage, his love will continue to bind you together. Those of us who were gathered, family and friends, as witnesses of Chad and Savannah's commitment to each other today, we have a responsibility to them. A responsibility to them as they journey through life together now as husband and wife. And our responsibility is one of love and one of support and one of encouragement as they share life together. As witnesses to this today, the question we need to ask ourselves is, what can I do to help Chad and Savannah have success, have a successful and a vibrant marriage and family? And one of the simplest things we can do to support Chad and Savannah is to commit to pray for them on a regular basis. And pray for them is what I would like for us to do now. And I'd like to invite all of you to join me in this. We're going to offer a prayer of blessing over Chad and over Savannah. And it's a super simple way that you can show your support of them. You're just simply going to raise your hands like this and point them towards Chad and Savannah, and it's basically you're saying, I've got this, we are with you today in this. So let's pray together, get your hands up, and let's offer a prayer of blessing for Chad and for Savannah. Father God, thank you for being here with us this evening and for this just this blessed event. And thank you for these two and how for who they are, and God, the uniqueness in which you've created them both, and how you've brought them together in such a neat and special way. And God, what we know you have great things for them. And God, right now I just pray a prayer of blessing over them. I pray for abundance in their life, spiritual abundance, financial abundance, God, abundance in their family and in their relationships. God, I pray for your favor to shine down upon them, and for them to be a blessed people. God, I ask that you be with them in their relationship. Bless them with their love and the richness of it. And God, bless them as a family as they come together and as parents. That would be such an amazing thing for them as they continue to raise Cody together. God, we can only ask these things because of your son, and because of what he has done for us. And so God, in the power and in the blood of Jesus, we ask for your abundant blessings upon Chad and Savannah and their life together. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen. Chad and Savannah, in so much as the two of you have agreed to live together in holy matrimony, have promised your love for each other by these vows, by the joining of your hands and the giving of these rings, it is a great honor that I now declare you to be husband and wife. Whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Congratulations, Chad. You may kiss your bride. for the first time as a married couple, Chad and Savannah Hungay.
I might look a little silly.